Tiger Mom is back in the headlines. Amy Chua, the Tiger Mother, wrote an op-ed in USA Today this week saying, quote, if in their early years we teach our children a strong work ethic, perseverance, and the value of delayed gratification, they will be much better positioned to be self-motivated and self-reliant when they become young adults. I mean, I think we could all agree on that, but there are some out there, including a New York Magazine article that says, you know, this push to excel in the classroom is not prepping many for the real working world. Carmen Wong-Ulrich is the author of The Real Cost of Living. Jeff Gardier is a clinical psychologist, and Jane Hyun is the author of Breaking the Bamboo Ceiling and is a leadership strategist and executive coach. I want to start with you, Jane. What is the bamboo ceiling? Because we hear from the Tiger Mother about excellence, a perfection in math, perfection at the piano, perfection in violin, only perfection, the best grades, the best degree. And then you write about the bamboo ceiling. What is that?
Yeah, thanks for asking.
You're welcome.
Bamboo ceiling, as I defined it, is a combination of individual, cultural, and organizational barriers that keep Asians from reaching the top ranks of companies. And so it's self-inflicted in the sense that there are cultural barriers or differences that impact our behaviors, but there are also some organizational barriers that keep us from really moving to the top.
We have, I think, 91% graduation rate from high school for Asian students. You know, that far and away is much better than any other ethnic group in this country, Carmen. Yet only 9 CEOs or executives of Fortune 500 companies are Asians or Pacific Islanders. So where is the gap between all of this talk about Tiger Mother and Tiger Children in the quote-unquote real world?
Well, not to be controversial here, but listen, we all have expectations when it comes to certain ethnicities or names. I'm the product of 2 very different expectations, being the Asian side and Hispanic side.
So your dad is Dominican.
My mother.
Your mother's Dominican.
Yeah. And the thing is that with the Hispanic culture, for example, there are very, very low education rates. And so the expectations there are very low. When it comes to the Asian expectations in the workforce, it's this kind of, we are excelling just as we did in school, but the problem becomes the personality that folks say or look at and say, you know, this person doesn't look like what I'm used to seeing a CEO look like, whether you're brown or whether you're another color or a woman. They don't see that. And is that the personality traits that you need? Are they there in your culture beyond the book learning? And that's a lesson that I learned early on out of college. It's a lot more than a meritocracy out here.
Right. Well, Jeff, you know, it's interesting because the battle hymn of the Tiger Mother, which was the extreme parenting story, has translated into the battle scars of the Tiger Children. And now you're hearing from all of these kids who are saying, oh, wait, it's not all it's cracked up to be. You know, I mean, it's, you can memorize all you want, but there are life skills that Tiger Mothers maybe aren't giving.
Well, that is the point, that when it comes to success, yes, you can be prepped and go to all these programs so you could do better on standardized exams, mm-hmm. but where are you developing the social skills so that when you get to college, you can hang out with all of these different ethnicities and get involved in sports and so on, because in the real world, that's where you excel. And then when you add on what we're not saying the term is, but I'll say it, the institutional racism or prejudice, when that becomes at play, the way that you're going to have to get through that is to learn to play the game the way that the majority do.
Mm-hmm. It's interesting because there was a discussion earlier this year at Davos, which is, you know, a big gathering of the world's leaders in Switzerland, and Amy Chua and Larry Summers, the former Treasury Secretary, and President of Harvard, actually got in kind of a tiff about this, and he said, look, the A students are professors. The C students are the wealthiest donors. I mean, think of that. It's interesting.
Yes.
You said people on average live a quarter of their lives as children. It's important that they be as happy as possible during those 18 years. He's really focusing on creativity, innovation, some of the things that, you know, driven parents may be forgetting when they're talking about the violin lessons and all that, Jane.
Absolutely. And I think that, you know, when I was doing research for the book, I found that I interviewed 100 executives, not just Asians, because I wanted to get a broad view of what does it take to actually be a leader in a company. And I found that there are different stages of a leader's development. In the beginning, actually, it's important that you are an individual contributor, that you work hard, that you put in the hours, that you put your head down. At some point in the game, though, the requirements of your leadership skills change. And so you need to kind of move away from being an individual contributor to someone who can build credible relationships. And so the rules change. And I think people sometimes forget that once you work starting a company, you might need to figure that out.
You know, Carmen, I think there's something for everybody to learn in both of these extremes.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
I mean, and that's what's so interesting here.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's what Amy followed up with her. She had an op-ed in the USA Today.
Exactly.
It has to be this combination of both. And I think I feel very lucky because I had both. I had this, you know, be a straight A student, excel in everything. But I also had a mother who was very, very savvy when it came to how to manage manage relationships in the workplace and how you need to be in this country. And I think the advantages is for all of our groups, whether it's ethnic or racial groups in America, is there is this American culture of the succeeding, and how to succeed has to be about more than just doing a great job.
Jeff Gardner, thank you so much. Carmen Long-Ulrich, thanks.
Thank you.
Jane Hyun, thank you so much. The book is called Breaking the Bamboo Ceiling. Another one's in the works, so we'll get you when that one comes out.